This is my second video on radicals. I am continuing to discuss simplifying radicals. My first video had numbers under the radical, now I have variables. My next video will combine them, and then we can move on to playing with our radicals. Playing means to add, subtract, multiply, and divide. Variables under a radical tend to be a little bit easier than numbers. The square root of a variable can be thought of that number to the exponent 1/2. What does this mean? It means that every exponent under the radical just needs to be divided in half. But wait, 9 isn't even. So what we're going to do is I'm going to start off by rewriting this as the square root of x to the 8, y to the 8, y to the 1, because 8 plus 1 is 9, so I just pulled off that remainder before I divide. And then 8 divided in half is 4. 8 divided in half is 4. And the 1 can't evenly be divided in half, so it stays under the radical, square root of y. For the next example, where we have the cube root, if you didn't know, the cube root of a number is the same as that number to the power of 1/3, which lets you figure out all the rest of the radicals. Whatever radical you have is the same as that number to the 1/ that number. Once again, we're kind of stymied by a 14. 3 does not go into 14, so we need to deal with the remainder first. So 3 goes into 12, so we have the cube root of h to the 12, but to get down to 12, we had to subtract off 2 of them. And 3 does go into 21, so I'll just leave the 21 there. 12 divided by 3 is 4, h to the 4th. 21 divided by 3 is 7, k to the 7th. And that 2 stays under a cube root. Don't forget when you write this answer to put that 3 in the V. If you leave the 3 out, you're turning the cube root into a square root, which inherently changes the problem. I hoped dealing with variables under radical makes sense, and I'll see you on the next video. If you enjoy this, please subscribe, share, tell your friends about it. Thank you.